We know that sources are never perfect. As we found out when we tried to measure the internal resistance of that 9-volt battery, we found that even batteries have some kind of character that can be modeled as an internal resistance. Knowing that sources aren't perfect, I now want to ask the following question. What resistance, R sub L, in this circuit would allow the maximum power to be transferred from the source to the load? That's what we're going to calculate, given that the source has a particular source resistance of RS. The power in the load resistor here is V squared divided by R. Let's now find V sub L in terms of our source voltage, V sub S. We can use a voltage divider. Let's square it and substitute it into this equation for power. What I'd like to do now is the following. I want to find the maximum power as a function of the load resistance. In order to maximize something, we need to take the derivative and set it equal to zero. So let's take the derivative of this equation with respect to the load resistance R sub L. To take the derivative of this fraction here, in the numerator, we're going to take the bottom times derivative of the top minus the top times derivative of the bottom. And then in the denominator, it'll be the bottom squared. We can cancel out one term of RL plus RS from the numerator. To find the extreme, or the maximum power, we need to set this derivative equal to zero. If I set this fraction equal to zero, I know that the numerator has to be zero. The voltage cancels from these two terms. We're then left with a single equation. If I have a voltage source with a source resistance R sub S, in order to transfer the maximum amount of power from the source to the load resistor, I should choose a load resistor that's equal to the source resistor. For example, if I had a source with an internal, mathematically modeled source resistance of 10 ohms, then if I wanted to extract the maximum power from that source, I should choose a load resistor of 10 ohms. That being said, it doesn't mean that maximum power corresponds to maximum efficiency. Let's find the point of maximum efficiency for the same circuit. Let's first define efficiency. We can define efficiency as the ratio of power delivered to the load resistor to the power supplied by the source. Let's say that we have a current I coming out of this source. Then the power delivered to the load will be I squared times R sub L. The total power supplied by the source, though, will be I squared times the total resistance along this circuit path. That will be I squared times RL plus RS. The current cancels from this equation, and we're left with a ratio of RL divided by RL plus RS. I don't have to take a derivative in this particular problem because the value of the load resistor that maximizes the efficiency is obvious. If we want the efficiency to be maximum, then we need a large term in the numerator and we need a small term in the denominator. The efficiency approaches 100% as the source impedance gets small, or effectively as the load impedance gets large. Of course, we know that we want the source impedance or the source resistance to be as small as possible. The smaller the source resistance, the more perfect the source. But assuming that we have a source that we can't change, a source with a fixed, internal, mathematically modeled source impedance, then if we want that source to operate at maximum efficiency, we should use a large load resistor. If we use a large load resistor, though, we're not going to transfer maximum power. On the x-axis here, we've plotted the ratio of load resistance to source resistance. As you can see, the power transfer is maximized when this ratio is 1, or effectively when the load resistance equals the source resistance. But the efficiency reaches its maximum point, that is, 1, at an infinite load resistance. If you're designing a circuit and the goal is to try to efficiently transfer power from a source to a load, then it generally makes sense to try to operate that circuit with as high a load resistor as you can get away with. But keep in mind that as you increase the value of that load resistor, the actual numerical value of power delivered will tend to drop. The power will rise if you lower down the load resistance, and it will reach its maximum value when the load resistance is equal to the source resistance. If you enjoyed watching this video, then you might be interested in following our playlist and learning more about the fundamentals of electrical circuits.